approximately 10 lines from the top of the section begins on page Kuvov. The line begins with the word nirgush. Want to give it a count? Nirgash.
About a third into the page, that's all.
Yeah, 9 lines at that, 10 lines, 9 lines. Okay. He explains that there are two madreges in ha-sagah, in sechel, in meichin. The etzem ha-meichin and the chitzenis ha-meichin. Or what we described in terms of approach, ha-sagah directly, in etzem ha-dobo, or ha-sagah b'levushei ha-sagah. A soga that is accomplished and comes down to the person through levushei ha-soga, to garments of ha-soga. Which means you're massing it indirectly. We discussed this, levushei ha-sagah. Where the inyan that your masik is presented in some kind of a graspable format. The high madrega is when it is be'etzem. What kind of hasoga can a human being have, and where does he get it from, that he has be'etzem ha-dover? The reason that he can have hasoga be'etzem ha-dover is that he is connected to etzem ha-dover. In other words, if a human being perceives himself as being in the world and part of the world, and he wants to understand and be masing the kus in from that perspective, from that stance, then he has to be levushei ha-sagah. And the motion for this, and the most simplest, and I hope we can focus in, this is something which we can really experience. The difference between observing the goings-on in the room from outside, through the window, although it's a full-fledged observation. Compare that to when you are actually inside the room. And we pointed out an interesting thing. On the one hand, when you were inside, you cannot see everything that there is to be seen, like you can see from through a window. You look from the window, you can see, you can look in every direction, up and down in every direction. Whereas when you were inside, you can only see that which is close to you, right in front of you. You don't see in behind you. And yet still, when you're inside, you have a completely different sense of what, of where you are, or what this union is. You have a real hasoga, a real relationship. You have a sense of what kind of reality this is. And the difference between these two is that when you're inside, you are taking, you are relating and recognizing the reality of this room where you are directly. You're not telling yourself that you are in the room. And you do not identify things in the room by reflecting their usage. You are there. Whereas when you are observing, you are taking things, what we call the levushei ha-sagah. You're interpreting everything that you see. This is called levushei ha-sagah. So the Rebbe explains the next step, that if you understand things be levushei ha-sagah, then you remain a separate entity. And as such, you have to translate what you see, what you understand, from your perspective. Why am I interested in this? Why do I see it? And this is why, okay, this is the line that we are on, nirgush bazeh ha-toiv de la cruz. But you sense in this the toiv de la cruz and the goodness of the cruz. In other words, the effect of the cruz rather than the cruz as it is a truth unto itself. And then furthermore, not only you magish ha-toiv de la cruz, the goodness of Elokus, not the truth of Elokus per se. But there it is, nirgash bivchinas hegesh atzmi, as we discussed. In a mode of hegesh atzmi, of a personal hegesh. Meaning to say, in next words, eshe kirvash elokim mitoiv. His magish, not only his magish, the goodness of Elokus, his magish, how Elokus is good for me. Which means that he is still a primary presence in this whole understanding. The whole understanding is due to his personal experience. It's not a real connect. And as we explained, and pointed out, the phenomenon of sechel, begashmius, the motion of sechel is sight. Sight is an absolutely pure direct connect. There is no. There is no transition from what you from seeing to recognizing that you see it. You don't make sense of what you see before you say, oh yeah, I see it. And the reason that is because sight is a complete and pure recognition, pure connect to the reality around you. That's why it's a direct knowledge, and there is no personal involvement in this sight. It's not a personal conviction that I see. I see it, as we said the other day, because it is there. That is the principle of moichin. But moichin at a lower level. Moichin, when it does not connect totally. But there is a chitzenius, where you when the moichin are presented to a person, to an entity, who is outside of that which he comprehends. He doesn't connect to Elokus directly. From his vantage point, he sees Elokus. there is not a pure and a complete union. But you know the lakus via the process as it is recognized from his vantage point. And therefore he goes to the realm of never when he right away recognizes Hatoyb Dalakus, the goodness of Alakus. Not the pure truth of Alakus, but the goodness. Goodness means how it affects, so to speak, its surrounding, it affects where it is. And then furthermore, even Tevli, the personal experience, the personal acceptance. There's a personal reason why I accept it. This is even further from the absolute truth. Okay, now at the end of this line that began, that we started nirgush b'zeh ha-tov v'lakus, eifei kibbutz ha-kibbutz mitov v'hainu. And the reason for that is that his comprehension of lakus is not pure. And it immediately involves, so to speak, a personal aspect in it. I know this is mipnei because shehat tfiso he, that the tfiso means the relationship, the recognition of the presence of Elokus, is he is b'madreges Elokus, is in those madreges of Elokus. That is Bekiruv, that is close to the creations. Not the Elokus as it is. Super presence, which is not known, which is the Knivroyin, the creation. Does not attest to this Elokus. You know this Elokus not via the attestation of the creation, but because of the truth of Elokus itself. We have that capacity, so to speak, as the Rambam says, to know that there is a first being, absolutely no prior cause. But here, when it comes to levushei ha-sagah, he knows he relates to Elokus, not the Elokus as it is unto itself, but the Elokus ha-shayach al hanivroyim, the Elokus that pertains to the creation. Bechinas kirov al hanivroyim. And the Elokus that is bechinas kirov is in a close proximity to the creations. In other words, what in fact is so significant about the Elokus? It is the Creator. The Toif is, we continue further. The Toif is ha-inyan b'levushei ha-sagah, and thus he grasps this inyan. He recognizes the sinyan, b'levushei ha-sagah, via the presentation of b'levushei ha-sagah, the means of comprehension of that, how it is presented. Which means, she'ein ho'odom yoytzi b'zeh mihag shomosu, that the person who is actually employing and involved in this moichin, he does not step out, he's not lifted from his gashmius, from his courses, from his worldliness. Even though he thinks of Elokus, he knows Elokus, understands Elokus, but the Elokus itself comes to him through his, to his mitzvahs. And therefore, even though he is a moichin, he comprehends Elokus, he remains in his hagshoma. Hagshoma means in his worldly principle of reality. Adirabo, on the contrary, ho'inyan bo b'hakshomos sichloi. The inyan that he comprehends comes to him along with hakshomos sichloi, along with making his sechel more megushim, giving his sechel a gashmizik, a worldly cognizance, a worldly presence. Bakshama sikhli. Normally, as we said, normally, he's going to elaborate on this. Again, turning back to sight. Sight is a very, very apropos and a very useful illustration of the inyan between learning of meichin, because sight, everybody knows, everybody experiences that sight is totally beside himself. He's not involved in the process of what he of the observation, of the recognition. Unless he intentionally brings it down to his level and keeps himself down in his action. But per se, sight is clearly telling him there is a world, there is a reality. Nothing to do, unrelated to his experience. If he should insist of seeing only that which he can make sense of it, so this is like making the sechel b'hakshama sichli. He is reducing his sechel to a gashmizdike level of acceptance, rather than a sechelike level of acceptance. And this is possible, as you said, it's possible to pervert one's sight to that extent. Derech klal. I go back to the line by the parentheses. So first he said, "Adarabba ho'inyan bo b'hakshama sichli." He does not really step out. He's not lifted out of his hakshama. On the contrary, the inyan that he comprehends, the God in that he comprehends, is translated and is known by Hakshama Sichli by lowering his seichel, by giving his seichel a tangible presence. Now in the parentheses, before Ve'enei Kmoi, Ve'enei Kmoi Hakshama and Midas, it is not like the Hakshama of Midas. So before the Ve'enei should come the word however. However, Einoi Kmei Hakshama Dan Midas. Even though this Hakshama Sichli, it is not using the Seichel at its prime level. It is drawing the Seichel down to a Gashmizike presence. But Einoi K'moy HaShomet HaMidus, this is not similar to HaShomet HaMidus, to the way the Midus are Mizgashe. HaShomet HaMidus is more HaShomet. HaShomet HaMidus is focused entirely on the experience of the person, rather than what he's experiencing. Ubiderach klal, the Rebbe says, in general, we can never dismiss the significance of sechel of the meichin, because ubiderach klal b'chol ha-sagah sechlis, in every ha-sagah sechlis, in every comprehension that is a sechli a comprehension, that only the sechel, so to speak, substantiated, harei hu b'vchinas aliyo v'hiskashus, it is in a status, in a stance of Haliyah v'yiskashus, Haliyah rising v'yiskashus and connecting le'inyan shelamayla mimano to something that is above himself. This is ha-sagah sechlis. This is a primary difference between sechel and midos. Sechel, although it's possible in sechel also to draw it down to hakshama and so forth, but sechel per se is a state where one understands things and looking to rise up to something higher. Hiskashus lehinyan shelamayla mimenu, binding, attaching himself to something which is above him. Ukmo shekosu b'makim achi, as I explained elsewhere. This is the principle of seichel. Ach, however, kasher hu bilvushei ha-sagah, when the seichel itself is taken levushei ha-sagah to the means and the garments of ha-sagah. It is presented via, so to speak, a worldly reality. Then, even though this is sechel, and even though this is meichin, and meichin per se connects him to something above him, still he does not thereby, because it's levushei ha-sagah, therefore he doesn't force him to step out of himself. And it's a b'zeh mimhusa. He does not step out of his mimhusa, of his reality. V'hareihu v'mamodim atzovoi. He can understand the lekus and remain in his primary state of who he is. He can understand the lekus and remain from his vantage point. But Mamodin also, which is not on the lekus by the lekus parameters. So if essentially he understands the lakus, but he translates that which he understands by presenting it to himself, bilvushei ha-sagah, by presenting himself first in his mamad, in his worldly perception. Not the way a lakus is higher than world. Okay, right after the parentheses. V'alkein, and therefore, harei ze bekore bekiru v'la'ergesh, this is why it turns out, close to the hergesh, to the feel, to the sense, dirkim v'selikim li toif, that kivas helkim klosim delkus is li toiv, is good for me, because the li, the me, is a primary player in this whole comprehension. Shezehu, pardon me, which is ha-bechein. This is called what's known as bechein. In every sechel there is what's called the bechein. The bechein is that which surfaces at the end of the whole sechel dike process. And one goes through the whole process until he gets to the core, to the principle of what he understood. But because that he remains a presence and an entity, an important entity to be reckoned with, therefore it's the full comprehension comes b'chein when he identifies the b'chein. Then therefore, b'chein means then therefore, meaning how does that translate in my world? What does that have to do with me? Shehu yinyan moichin shebe midoi. This is in fact moichin shebe midos, moichin that are contained within midos.
It still remains moichin even though it went through the filter of what's in it for me.
That's right. It's still moichin, but it's moichin shebe midos. But the important thing is that the Rebbe says he understands mamash anin eliki. And that does not lift him out of his hakshub.
And that would be because everything is reduced to his or to his perspective.
That's right. Everything is understood from his perspective. Why am I pursuing this? I had to have a personal reason, personal interest.
And yet it still remains Eloki because it's a true grasp.
Because it's not a true grasp. It's a grasp of the truth. He still understands the Elokus, but he doesn't understand the Elokus by connecting to it. Like I said, you observe the room, you know everything inside the room, but you're not in there. You retain your observer's status. And if you retain the observer's status, you can always close your eyes and not see.
In the mashal, it's clear being outside and looking through the window versus being inside. In the nimshal, what is the guy doing or not doing?
If he steps inside, means that he completely gives up being a separate entity. Elokus is what defines who he is and where he is.
He foregoes entirely his previous orientation.
What he's about and what his world is about. Okay, I think the Rebbe did justice to us. You forced us to look inside ourselves. Ve'al kein, harei zeh bikirim al ha-hergesh kibbutz al-hitoiv. And therefore this remains at close proximity to the sense that Kivus Elikim Ritov, that Kivus Elikim is good for me, Shezeh HaBechein, which is only the Bechein, the result of this understanding, rather than the understanding itself. Shehuhi Emeichas Shemimidus, I'm repeating, I'm sure you won't get lost. Shehuhi Emeichas Shemimidus, which is the, it is Meichin, but it is Meichin as they are contained within Midus. In other words, I'm going out to understand the Lakus. But what's behind that? Why am I going out to understand the Lakus? It is to make sense and to give me peace of mind in my world. This is the beginning. Megan should be minus. Let's continue, let's see something brighter. Ma shein king she ha-sagah hi b'bchinas ha-pshoto mi levushei ha-sagah. In contrast, it's a completely different world. When the ha-sagah is in the manner of ha-pshoto mi levushei ha-sagah, of undressing, taking off levushei ha-sagah, means of comprehension. The first step of that is, levushei ha-sagah, is how come I see it? That's the first question, that's the first point where it draws you back into your coarseness.
The how come do I understand?
How come I see it? How is it that I see it? This is the phenomenal trick of the sultan, so to speak. He says, you know, you're very wise, you understand everything in the world. You know how come you see? Because there's a light hitting the object and hitting and reflecting into your eye. A complete physicalization of sight. And then you say, oh, now I understand what it is. Now you understand nothing. He blinded you to your own sight. Again, I'm starting from the line that begins Shehu Inyan. Teresh Teva, see the mamish in the middle. Merchan Shemini Yidish. Masha Ein Kein. Whereas, Kishe Ha-Sogah Yi Bibchinas Ha-Shoto Milbushi Ha-Sogah. Thank you very much. When the Ha-Sogah is Bibchinas, Ha-Shoto Milbushi Ha-Sogah. When one did... removes levushei ha-sagah, the means of ha-sagah. He does not prove to himself that he understands because he has these points, these pointers. But he has ha-sagah because he has a sechel, ki'in, but rather be'etzem ha-inyan ha-liki. He understands the etzem ha-liki because inyan ha-liki is a truth in itself. He doesn't need to substantiate it from his vantage point. Doesn't have to make sense of it from a worldly perspective. And the question is more real than the world. On the contrary, Rebbe also interferes with his view and his conviction of what he knows. He does not let him go where he wants to go.